Hi everyone and welcome back to Creative PowerPoint. Today, we'll learn how to make a walking character animation. We'll use this example of a person walking down a hall and scanning his mobile phone at a kiosk. Let's go! To animate this scene, we are going to do a precomposition. This means we will build the walk animation in a separate file with a transparent background that we will include in our final PowerPoint presentation. To build the movie snippet, I have created a PowerPoint presentation with the dimensions of the walking character. To set the dimensions of a PowerPoint presentation, go to the Design tab and select Slide Size. Then, I have drawn the different poses of our walk. I've started by drawing what we call a contact pose. This pose gets its name from the fact that both feet are in contact with the ground. The next pose is called a down pose. Here, the weight of the body is supported by the right foot. The body is lowering down by a bit. The next pose is called a passing pose. It's called a passing pose because one leg, here the left one, passes in front of the other. Notice that the right leg is in a straight vertical position. And finally, the last pose is called an up pose. The whole body is in this unstable position. It's called up pose because that's the position where the head is at its highest. Now that we've drawn our four poses, we are going to draw the four same poses, but exchanging the role of the left and right legs. We then have another contact pose, this time with the left foot at the front, then a down pose, a passing pose, and another up pose. With those eight poses, we've completed one walk cycle. I have duplicated this walk cycle three times, and I added one final slide with the character scanning his mobile phone. Before we see the animation, let's focus on the shapes for a moment. I've drawn all the shapes in PowerPoint using freeform shapes. If I right-click on one shape and select Edit Points, I can move the points that form the shape. I can also change the bezier handles to adapt the curvature of my shape. To help the morph transition be more efficient, you want to have as less points as possible. For example, here are the points that form the hand. I've also used an advanced technique to make sure that PowerPoint knows how a given shape on one slide relates to the other shapes on the next slide. To use this technique, open the selection pane. On macOS, you would go to the Home tab in the Arrange group and click on Selection Pane. On Windows, the selection pane is in the Editing group of the Home tab. You can see that I've given all my shapes a name starting with two exclamation marks. PowerPoint interprets those exclamation marks as a custom naming scheme for the morph transition. When it sees an object with that naming scheme, it knows that it needs to morph this object into the object of the next slide with the same name. For example, it will morph that leg into the form with the exact same name on the next slide. Let's animate our walk cycle to see the intermediate result. I've selected all slides and I made sure that the morph transition is activated for all of them. For all the slides of the walk cycle, I made sure the duration is 0.12 seconds. This corresponds to an average walk speed of 2 steps per second. I also made sure that every slide moves to the next one after 0 seconds. For the last slide with the phone movement, the animation duration is 1 second. Let's run the animation. We can see the walk cycle, but it's jagged and feels unnatural. This is because PowerPoint applies some smoothing in the morph transition between the slides. Unfortunately, at the moment, we cannot tell PowerPoint to stop doing this smoothing, so as a workaround, we will retime this animation outside of PowerPoint. Let's export our working character. Go to File, Export. Select Animated GIF for the format. Select Extra Large Image Quality. Ensure the background is transparent. And save your animation. Now, let's retime our animated GIF. We are going to use a free online tool. Let's go to onlinegiftools.com. Select Change GIF Playback Speed. Select Import from File. Your GIF should display. Set a default speed of 40 milliseconds. This corresponds to a frame rate of 24 frames per second. We also want the animation to hold on the last frame. We can see the last frame is number 101 in our case. Let's enable custom delay and type 101:60,000 milliseconds. Under the right GIF with new speed, click on Save As, Download, and save on your computer. For the final animation step, I've prepared my scenery in PowerPoint. Those are PowerPoint freeform shapes, and I have added a path animation to them so that they move to the left. Notice that the further away the shape, the smaller the movement. This creates this parallax effect. And I also added this close-up of the kiosk and made it appear after a delay of 4 seconds. Let's insert a working person. Go to Insert, Pictures, and select your file. I can resize the character as I need, position it at its starting point, and then I can add a path animation to move the character to the right. I'll set the animation duration to 3 seconds, deactivate the smooth start and end. I'll adapt the animation trigger to make sure the character starts working when the slide begins. Let's see the final result. Et voilà! And the answer is... Thanks for watching! Make sure you don't miss my upcoming videos. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share with your friends. And don't forget, every creative day has a creative PowerPoint. See you next week. Bye-bye.